We'll be throwing it all at the wall in this one. It's going to be a little bit design, CAD, CAM, CNC, 3D printing, woodworking, wiring, and a little bit... Quite a bit to cover here, so we're going to be breaking it up into a bunch of little videos. We don't know how many yet, but basically we've got to cover design, fabrication, detailing, and final assembly, and we're going to do an audio test and a shootout in the last one. A couple of shout outs before we jump in. First, to old friends Trig, Tim, and Tom from the band Electric Magma for donating some tracks you're going to be hearing in the construction stuff. If you like your playlist loud, groovy, sludgy, and unspoiled by vocals, there's no one better. Check them out on Spotify and everywhere else. Music is being exploited these days. They have a ton of albums, and you can get vinyl and swag at electricmagma.com. Next, Next Gen Guitars in Nepean, Ontario. They're a Canadian mom and pop shop. John and company went out of their way to help us with some obstacles we faced, and their prices were unbeatable. Check them out for all your DIY guitar gear building needs. And finally, my buddy Eric McPherson, who helped assemble the CNC machine and donated several hours to helping sort some of the unexpectedly finicky details of this build. I needed to pull together a bit of gear to finish a throwback music project I've been chipping away at for the last few years. The music is guitar-heavy, ham-fisted stuff, lots of feedback and noise. Now, as much as I love high-tech solutions for everything, the plug-in and in-the-box approach for this was all wrong. We had a few decent amps to play with, but they all kind of sound samey, sort of in that JCM800 world, especially out of a single beat-up Marshall 412. So the answer we came up with was more cabinets. Weird cabinets, custom cabinets. Having just added a Shapeoko XXL CNC router to our arsenal of toys at work, the opportunity for a super fun, large-scale project was becoming undeniable. I have a couple of orange heads that were lying around on the studio floor. They were crying out for a home. So using the amazing orange PPC cab aesthetic as a starting point seemed like a no-brainer. Conveniently enough, Orange has a great video that skims over the basics of how the cabinets are built. This was a great reference to get things off the ground for this particular build. You can find the link in the description. For this project, we'll be creating two cabinets. The top cab will be a 212 with an offset speaker lid. The cab will be loaded with two 12-inch 60-watt 8-ohm Celestion Vintage 30s. Most stock 212 designs from manufacturers are either open or closed back and are not convertible. In this case, we should be able to dramatically change from a tight, focused closed back sound to a boomy, spread out, open back sound in about 10 seconds by popping out a back panel with the flip of a few latches. When it's used on its own without a bottom cap, it can be flipped on its side, cutting the footprint of the rig in about half. Now, the height of the cabinet in its normal orientation perfectly matches the width of a standard orange tube head. The bottom cab is where the real fun is. It's a 212-115 design in a standard 412 form factor. Sleeper. The cab will be loaded with two 12-inch 60-watt 16-ohm Celestion Vintage 30s and an 8-ohm 15-inch Celestion fullback. Now, in the end, provided the kit doesn't rattle itself apart from janky construction, we'll basically have a 412 that can be partially opened and closed, plus the added low-end gut punch from a 15. These cabs will be built using 13-ply 18mm Baltic birch. The plywood is mostly void-free, which provides consistent density and is supposed to keep creaks and chatters to a minimum. Birch is commonly used because it's relatively lightweight and acoustically transparent, apparently. In this area, Niagara, the stock could only be sourced from a local specialty lumber store, and it was a bit pricey. And that's before lumber went nuts. It's sold in 5x5 sheets, and it's about $50 a pop. For this project, for both cabs, it'll take 4 sheets and you'll have a little bit left over. One thing to watch out for is thickness. It's sold as 3/4 inch. It's not, it's 18 mil, which comes out to about 0.71 inches. Now 0.04 inches doesn't sound like a lot, but it makes a huge difference when it comes to assembly. A good idea is to check the thickness with calipers once you actually get the stock on hand to make sure everything checks out. This model couldn't be easier to set up in CAD. The cabinets will be constructed using mostly simple box joints, so the meat of the CAD work is mostly a series of extruded rectangles. The most complicated modeling here was for the pre-made components, like speakers, handles, hardware, that kind of stuff. Now, once all the basics are covered and the assembly looks good, all the post-CNC by-hand detailing, like roundovers and B-channels, can be mocked up as assembly-level features in SolidWorks. That's how we did. This wasn't 100% necessary step, again, but never a bad idea to cover as many details as you can in the plan. It gives a much better preview of how the finished product will look and helps avoid unexpected surprises when moving from CNC to handheld power tools. In this case, loads of little tweaks were made after seeing an accurate representation of what the cabs would look like in 3D. Okay, that just about wraps it up for the design in the box stuff for this build. In the next one, I promise, we'll get into the really fun, satisfying, and loud business of making sawdust and bringing this design into the real world. Hopefully you'll join. Please like, subscribe, and share if you enjoyed this content. Hit the bell to get a notification when we drop the next episode. Also, be sure to check out our other build videos on our YouTube channel. Now, if you have any questions or suggestions or comments, be nice. Please leave them in the section below. And drop by our site to pick up some Bad Pixel swag or donate to our Patreon page at patreon.com/badpixel if you can. Thanks for watching. Take care. Stay safe. See you soon.